All right, we're on, I think. Your mic was on.
I don't know.
No, stop, move. It was good.
Text me when you're...
Will do. Will do, donkey. Yeah, you too.
Now it's on.
Yep, 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 yep. Yep, yep.
Oh, yep, what a week.
It's been a pretty wild week up here in this part of the world. Hey, get over here.
Uh-oh. What
do I do? Grab her.
Lisa's out of the car now.
Oh my God, there's a dead squirrel in the middle of the road.
That's awesome, dude.
Lisa's like, oh my God, there's a dead squirrel in the middle of the road.
That's awesome.
That's the good place for him, though.
Yeah, I mean, they do. You didn't even bark at her, dude. You're not even a good herder. I love you so much, but you didn't even look out for your sister.
So our last podcast, we were actually covered.
You didn't care that the dog was in the middle of the street?
I did care, but I saw that everybody was handling it, and therefore I assessed the situation and was like, my baby's in control. She's fucking getting her dog and looking at dead squirrels.
That look.
I love you. Have fun.
Remember, no, what was it?
No titty or kitty. Yeah. I guess that's the thing up at Nacimiento. It's...
Oh, that needs to be scooped up, I think.
The city should do it.
No, the birds will eat it.
A cat will get it.
Yeah, somebody will eat it. It's just let it go.
Well, you are in Templeton.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Somebody will get it.
Yeah, our last podcast was we were listening to the scanner about all the peaceful protests.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And then since that time, we've then had an active shooter for basically 2 days.
Yeah.
That killed a homeless guy at the train station in Paso and then injured four law enforcement
officers. Yeah.
And when they killed him, you were down in Tin City and...
No, I was already at the house. I was already home when that happened, dude.
But meaning the...
But I was down there. I was down. I mean, I got to work at like 8:30 in the morning.
And this all started when then?
Started the night before.
No.
Because they saw him, like, what started? Like, the search for him, or...
Yeah, when you saw it, like, everybody was coming to Tin City.
You could see that. That was happening already by 8 in the morning because they saw him at the Chevron station at 2 in the morning.
Oh, that's when he bought the energy drink.
That's when he bought Blue Power, and that's we judge him for that, too, and that's terrible. Because it's like a Gatorade, dude. But it's... 8 in the morning, the airplane was flying over... And then
that's right.
Probably about 10 a.m. was when the first helicopter showed up.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in the back weed whacking. Just doo-doo-doo.
Getting able to hear anything, right?
Oh, I could see, but I was in my head. I'm also thinking, I'm back by the beehive where we keep our bees. I'm like, he could be back in these fucking bushes.
And you're like, I gotta get out of here.
Well, at first I was like, whatever, it's not a big deal. And then I'm like, I thought about it. I'm like, ah,
it's probably a big deal.
I'm like, I should probably just get out of here. But I wasn't, I wasn't fearful. And then when everything happened, on the scanner, when it's like, he's over there, everybody started locking their doors. Like Sans Liege locked their doors and we locked our doors and we're inside looking at each other and they've got the scanner app, we've got the scanner app.
Right.
And that's when we were just hearing. And then we heard about how they were going down Valopi Isabel and going up the creek. And then I dipped out. Like, did a quick live thing on Instagram.
Yeah, I saw that.
And then...
You're so funny, dude. He wanted to go down.
Oh, I totally... If I wasn't married, man, I totally would go down there and do that stuff.
Yeah, you would have, like, no fear. Like, just would have gone down and tried to get what you could get.
Yeah, dude.
That's so cool.
I mean, realistic...
It's fun, man.
It's super fun. I mean, it's not that it's fun, like, oh, my God, it's fun, but it's...
It's an adrenaline rush.
It's very much so.
You're able to capture the action from a citizen point of view.
Exactly.
What we get told by law enforcement.
Exactly. Exactly.
And I know, because I think law enforcement did a really good job. I just know that I don't think we're ever going to really know all the truth.
You know, if there's anybody out there who knows anybody who lives up in, what is that area that's above the river right there?
On the far side?
Spanish Ranch or whatever?
No, Santa Isabel Ranch.
If anyone lives up there and saw that shit go down in the riverbed... Right. Man, I would get a hold of me. I would love to talk to you. Just from a different perspective, you know?
Yeah, because they're right.
They're above the river looking down at it, dude.
So I wonder how much they could actually see. And that would all be based on if this guy was in a heavily covered brush area.
It was, there was a line of trees along the.
Oh, yeah, you showed me on the map.
Yeah, a line of trees along the.
So he was.
The Salinas River.
Well covered, I'm sure.
He was able to move. I mean, he was going south in the riverbed, so he was probably like waiting until nighttime and stuff and then moving.
It was a trip too. I saw the photos of apparently there's this space where there's a grate that he broke down.
Yeah, Todd Jones was talking about that.
And it's like, but I saw photos that somebody shared online, and it's like you look underneath, and it's like that was where he was hiding the first night. Like, just such a trip, dude. I don't know. It was weird. What is that?
TCC light, guys. It's coming out Father's Day.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Right on. We'll have to come in for that. So yeah, I don't know. Crazy times, dude. But that's over. Now we're back to the regularly scheduled programming of COVID-19 and a fucked economy.
It's wild,
did
dude.
Did you see Trump on video drinking the water?
He does drink water, trippy. No.
He went like this with one hand, and then he couldn't get it the rest of the way, so he went.
Maybe he just wanted, he's
everybody's like he had a stroke or some shit.
He wants his hand, he wants to be equal.
He's like, ooh, yeah.
Yeah, he wants to help his hand out. No, I just, there's so much stuff going on, it's wild. Like with the protests in Seattle and how they've taken over Capitol Hill area.
Didn't they take over like 7 blocks?
Yeah, it's 7 blocks, but it's a fucking shit show.
So it's
dude.
Like it's a no police zone now is what the citizens have made it, right?
They've made it like that, but even in their that place, there's like the laws of nature taking over, like this is what I've heard. I can't confirm this one. Mm-hmm. But I heard that like straight up gangsters went in there and then were just like fucking with guns and they're like, we're taking over.
Wouldn't surprise me though.
And that's, because it's like all these little, you know, kids who are woke or whatever. And I love protesting, but what you guys are doing is dumb.
I like protesting when you actually have like a real cause.
Something is going to change. You're not changing anything. You're only furthering the advance of a fucking complete police society.
Well, and like to me though, it's funny because they go in and they we're done with this. We're gonna do it ourselves. How are you gonna get your trash picked up? Who's gonna enforce the streets? You all are gonna turn on each other.
Oh, they are. Yeah, they already.
You know what I'm saying? It's like
they are. I mean, I'll read you something. A couple things I saw on Twitter. So they planted a garden.
Oh fuck.
And
downtown Seattle, somewhere where we were, there was a downtown garden.
No, it's not like that at all.
Different kind of garden?
No, they're trying to grow food, but it's like
do they know how?
Fuck no, dude.
Little woke fuckers.
It is absolutely, you gotta see this. I gotta show it to you. So these kids returning to the Chaz struggle. Look at that garden. It's on fucking cardboard boxes and just topsoil.
They think that's gonna work?
Yes.
What in the fuck, dude? Yeah, it's a bunch of cut down cardboard boxes all laid out.
With topsoil on it.
Like, what, about that much?
Yeah.
They're growing that.
They're not, it's like you guys are out of your minds.
Oh, Lord.
So, yeah, but there's other things. And it's just, it's dumb. And then I saw a thing where somebody was posting on Twitter. They said the Hells Angels and the Mongols are going up there together because they want to start shit.
Oh my god.
And that's not confirmed either, but I saw it on Twitter and a couple different people reposted it.
Oh, that's so funny.
And I was like, holy shit, man.
Like to go up and just fuck with the woke people?
With the Antifa kids. They're like, fuck this. God. This is America. This is why we do it. Because a lot of those guys are old vets and stuff.
Oh, for sure. Well, that's what happened. We saw that here that day when the Mongols and the, the Molochs and the Vagos were in downtown Paso when the protests went on here to keep the businesses safe.
Everybody fucking loves sans anarchy, but then when they actually come out, people get scared.
All they're like, why are those guys here?
So,
yeah, I don't know, man. It is definitely crazy times. But ever since that dude got capped over here, I don't know. Like, I think the city kind of feels a little more like calm.
Yeah, there's an energy release. Everybody has built up energy, and you're all together.
Right.
It's part of that hive collective.
Right.
And so once that happened, the community, it's a communal sigh of relief.
Oh yeah. Exactly.
You know, and just releasing that energy, that the crap that's on you and all the negative. I'm good, man.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of like because we've had all this other negativity to where this kind of like brought the community together. We were all.
But then there's things. Firestone got. Blast, not Firestone, I apologize. Barrel House got blasted on social media.
Because they want to do dollar six packs?
Because they were doing something where they just were thanking the police or something like that. And just people were like, you didn't talk about Black Lives Matters, you didn't do this, you didn't do that. And so they got lit up. It was just like, man.
That's why they...
But I told Russell was talking about it, and I said, you're fucking fool. Who gives a fuck what they say?
Exactly right. But they did come out and say something about that with a post. I didn't see all that commentary.
I didn't see it at all.
There was another one that came out.
I'm
after
off
that.
Facebook. I've been off for like 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
You feel better, huh? Although Twitter to me is more of the shit show. On Facebook, I can control my shit a little bit better than Twitter. Twitter's more of a fire hose.
It's a fire hose.
It's just all about who you follow, though. But
it's true.
Yeah, they came out and said something about trying to like bring more diversity to Barrel House and this and that. So apparently that backlash, it's so fucking dumb. Anyway, whatever. I think people should speak out about what they want to speak out about.
Yeah.
And there, if there's other shit you don't want to get involved in, don't get involved. It's not wrong or right. You got to do you.
That's pretty much it.
But I thought it was cool, though. They basically came out with... So the law enforcement thing, everybody kind of got behind them, and it was really cool.
Oh, I saw a certain Paso. They did, like, blue runs everywhere,
dude. All downtown is covered in blue ribbons and shit like that. And then Chief Ty Lewis came out, and he was being interviewed, and he goes... You could hear the crowd off to the side, yeah, like, cheering for him. And he was, like, wiping away tears, and he was like, just the support from the community. And, you know, so it was an overwhelming 2 days for his department.
Yeah.
Stressful, man, because you have the community being like, why can't you catch him yet, you know, because there were those people that were talking shit. Then the rest of us were just like, we will do what you tell us to do, like, let's just get this guy found before he causes more.
Yeah, they put Templeton on 2 mile radius on shelter in place.
Well, it's like damn near the whole town, except if you get,
well, I mean, it's 2 miles pretty much from here to there. My house to there is really? 2 miles.
So
exactly.
You were on shelter in place here at home.
Yeah, they pretty much anywhere like,
well, that's so anywhere close to.
I wonder what they did with Target and all that, if they stayed open or.
That's a big corp, dude. They're not going to shut down.
Today, yeah, it was wild. But I mean, it goes in, and then it leads into the discussion. It's like the guy who had, he had mental health issues, dude.
He had another one. But how many times do we hear that? How many times do we hear about a crazy shooter that doesn't have mental health issues? Very little. Most
they
of
all,
them do.
Yeah. There's just got to be, I mean...
Well, his dad even came out and he said, yeah, he refused to take his medication.
And that's the issue.
When
if someone's schizophrenic,
right,
and they refuse, it's like there's nothing you can do. I mean, what do? Do you go back to the old days where they had institutions where you
and
would
you
just
literally lock them up?
And you lock them up. Yeah, you force them to go because that's what it used to be.
But is that freedom?
I mean, that was even... That went on... One flew over the cuckoo's nest. That was in the 70s, dude.
Right, exactly, right.
So, I mean, that stuff still... Mental institutions, I mean, we've got Ash down there.
In Atascadero, yep. People have talked about turning that boys' home that's up near the airport,
yeah,
in Paso, into something. It sits empty right now. They've talked about doing something with the homeless population in North County and using that as a place for them to be. But how can you legally hold them? But instead, we let them live in the riverbed and...
Well,
how do you take away somebody's rights if
that's,
they want to go live
exactly,
in the
riverbed? Dude. That's exactly.
Like, what do you do?
What do you do?
So what would you do about homelessness or mental health? Either one.
You just if someone wants help,
help them.
Help them. I mean,
and then the rest of them, you're just like, okay, live in the downtown park.
If not in the park, no. It's like, I'm sorry, you can't live in public spaces like that. It's right. As a collective, we're a public space.
So it'd be like, okay, you have to go live in the woods, or our version of the woods would be go live in the riverbed.
Yeah, but I mean. Then it's like, what do you do? Because it's like, you drive on the freeway and you see the encampments are just shitholes, dude.
Yep.
And, I mean...
In the winter, it's a problem, because if we do get heavy rains...
It washes it all.
Rescued and shit.
That was 2 years ago, huh?
Yeah.
That old guy? There was an old guy in the riverbed, like an old homeless guy.
Well, I think it was 2 or 3 years ago, they were using helicopters,
yeah,
to pull people out and rescue, like, the homeless guy's dog and all this shit. And it's like...
Yeah, so what, I mean,
how much money does that cost?
But does money even matter? I mean,
Well, essentially, money does matter, because even though I don't like it the way it currently sits, like, money is the foundation. That helicopter needs to go up. Those guys on,
yeah,
board need to get paid.
Yeah.
Like, and it's overtime work,
yeah,
whatever. So it's like, where is that coming from? It's not from the homeless guy.
No.
It's from the people that work. It's from businesses. It's, you know, taxes.
But then where is the taxes? But then our taxes are going to fucking shit.
Well, apparently, though, too... They're like, we don't have enough money to fix healthcare, but then they throw out these trillions of dollars to give to corporations during this pandemic bullshit. And it's like, where did that money come from then?
Exactly. That was my point I was getting to.
So it's like, what is going on there?
Exactly. And then
or
when
aren't
you're
they just at the point now where they're literally,
I don't know,
just
dude,
like printing money, like whatever the fuck they feel like.
The fact that I saw CDF firemen.
Oh, this is great. This was great. I blew my mind that you said that.
I left and I'm coming up Ramada and I get to Main Street.
This was when...
This was during all of it, so it was about...
Day before yesterday.
Yeah, about 3 o'clock, right around there, and they're rerouting everybody. Nobody's allowed to go on Ramada at all.
Right.
And and I come up, and the fire truck's there, and they were CDF, because...
So CDF fire
the
truck.
The blue CDF... I see the CDF, and I see he has CDF on his shirt, two guys.
The blue shirts.
Yeah, the blue shirts. But they had tactical gear on.
You said helmets and shit?
Tactical helmets.
And what were
one
they
guy, one guy had a full-on M16...
I didn't know that was a thing.
I didn't know firemen carried them. And so that trips me out, because there's programs that give fire departments and police departments and everything like that used military equipment. It's like, if you're trying to...
Oh, it's like shit that you... So the military used to use it, or like maybe National Guard. Now it's kind of old. They get new stuff.
Yeah.
And then they
give it to them.
Police departments can buy it, or it's given to them.
It's like there's grants for it, where they can get a grant and then get it.
Oh, no shit.
So there's programs where they get all this stuff, dude. And so it's... Why would you want to militarize...
Maybe for shit like that? I don't know.
But that's the thing. It's like... So you... That's... But for safety, you're giving up... You're allowing a police state to be in force.
I have a question for you then. Let's say, so what, these areas that have had peaceful protests but then have also had rioting and looting and buildings caught on fire, do you believe in us sending in our National Guard or military just to stand in front of these places to where people can't loot and riot and all that?
But yeah.
The peaceful protesters go, do you think letting the military in for that would be okay?
If the local people can't fucking handle it, I guess
the local
so.
Police stations can't.
Yeah, if they can't handle it, like if it's getting out of control or there are... But it's like, it's weird sitting by and watching the police allow them to burn their police cars, allowing them to do stuff, and they're just standing by and you're like, why are you... What the fuck are you doing?
But in a lot of those situations where they let the crowds do that sort of shit or flip the cars over, it's oftentimes because the number of people are far outnumbering the number of police officers.
For sure, but then they bring in like they
apparently
use CDF. Yeah, CDF. Well, they have tear gas, they have, you know, they have what did you see when then in Paso when they were doing the flashbangs or whatever?
Where?
Oh man, I saw footage where it was like that night they were looking for him. They were
the first night.
Yeah, they were doing flashbangs down the alley, and that's why, cuz Lisa was supposed to get her hair done by Pam.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
and
yeah,
she couldn't because she's like, I've been up all night. And so I'm sure you heard those going off as well. Pop, 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 pop.
I never heard anything. I don't think we would have heard. I mean, where we live.
I don't know if you would hear it from your house.
So they were throwing flashbangs
in the alleys to like stun, like those flash things that stun people.
Just be like, oh, is he there?
Yeah.
Wow.
But they make a noise.
Well, and they light up for a minute. Yeah. But then, yeah, like the concussion from it can kind of jack you up. Holy shit. I had no idea.
Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy, dude.
Twitter.
So then flashbangs going. I never knew too that under the Geneva Convention, apparently, like tear gas and all that shit, is you can't do that in war, but police can do that in the streets in protests and shit like that.
It's wild.
You would think it'd be opposite.
You would think.
Like, hey, we're in war. Like, let's use tear gas and all the other shit. But no, but you can use it against your own citizens.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, man. It's some of these things are tough for me to kind of navigate what my opinion on it is, because it's like, well, kind of the analogy I use for Annie is like when anytime the government gets into talks about like women's health or abortion, it's like, I'm a guy. Well, I have no right to say anything. Like,
yeah.
It's not my responsibility. You know what should happen is instead of a group of white men getting together to talk about women's health, it should be a group of women, you know, from all backgrounds that get together and write those bills, not us.
Yeah.
And same thing with, like, you know, Black Lives Matter or, you know, the police stuff. Obviously, there's a problem, because if there wasn't a problem, you know, these people wouldn't be trying to, like, stand up and have this uprise against the system. But as a white guy, it's like, I'm with you, but it's like, yeah, like, I see other white people going, like, oh, there's not systemic racism, there's not this, there's not that. And you're like, dude,
it's foolish to it's foolish. Well, it's just foolish to deny that. It's like... All you got to do
is... our law. Look at our prisons.
Yeah, it's foolish to say that that's not happening.
But
I mean,
constantly.
Well, that's just... It's somebody wanting to just believe their own narrative, I guess. But even then, for us to say, no, that's not happening, there, girl, you're believing your own narrative.
It's true. I mean, well, that can be tossed at anybody over any issue on either side, right?
Yeah. So, but it's... If you look at facts, it really is real. And it's like... It's a real thing. There's no denying it, but it's like how each person handles it and deals with it, you know? Like, I don't... I I don't want to go out and protest. It's not my jam.
Right.
But I,
yeah,
you know,
there'd probably be some people that are like, oh, that's part of the problem is that we need everybody to stand up with us. And it's like, I don't want to go. I'm with you. Like, I think everybody deserves the exact same rights. Period. End of discussion. It shouldn't be that difficult.
But all you have to do is look at human fucking history.
Right.
No one has rights.
Well, especially when it comes down to like the leaders, the governments,
civilizations. They all rise and fall, and it's based on, a lot of them are built on slave trade. A lot of them are built on the backs of fucking conquered people who become slaves.
Well,
that's the way it is. I mean, people, it's crazy.
And it's constantly throughout history. That's the cycle.
Throughout, and we're just in one cycle of it right now. I mean, people are trying to fight it, but it's like, I feel bad to say this, but it's like, it's not going to end.
No, I don't think it's going to end. Well, I think that's the thing. Like, even though we know our history, like, for some reason, we just constantly repeat it. Like, it's just the same shit.
As a species.
Right. Right. So, like, so 6 months from now, is the big thing going to be a second wave of COVID? Everybody shelter in place again?
If we have the second wave, it should happen in fucking 2 weeks.
Well, that's fair, too. Well, we're seeing it in Texas and Arizona.
I don't believe any of their fucking numbers.
What do you think's wrong about the numbers? Because I have my opinion.
Oh, they're trying to inflate it again to lock it down or to control. It's just a control narrative is what it is.
Right. So I think the number of cases is actually higher than what's being reported because not everybody's been tested, right?
Yeah.
So we don't know. So I think that's higher. The number of deaths, I think, is lower because we're hearing so many times where people go in and they're like obese, had a heart attack 6 months ago, and they have COVID, and they're just labeling it a COVID death. And it's like...
It's not.
It's, come on, dude. It's like a number of things. It's not just COVID.
Yeah.
You know, so if that guy was obese, had a heart attack, and COVID, he died from 33% COVID.
Yeah.
So we have to adjust the death number, too. We've only had one death in our county, and that was back in fucking mid-April.
And he was 80 years old in hospice.
In hospice. Like...
He was dying anyways. If your family watching, doubt it, but no offense to you.
Hey, I don't watch it.
Doubt it.
But that's a fair statement. He's 80, in hospice... And then they're going to label it a COVID death.
Yeah, my uncle's in the hospital right now with gangrene. Yeah, pretty gnarly.
What happened?
He got it in his foot, and then...
How old is he?
He's maybe 69, 70.
Got it. Did he have, like, an injury there, and then it turned gangrene?
Probably. He's probably just didn't even give... Probably, he probably got an infected toenail, probably like Bob Marley.
And he was just like, fuck it?
Yeah, and then...
What do they do with that? Don't they amputate?
They will if it gets bad. I guess they did surgery and they were able to get a lot of the shit out and they packed it. And they were going to give him 3 days. And then if not, they were going to amputate, which is worried because it was going to his heart.
Oh, that's not good, yeah.
Yeah, so... But would they list my uncle's death as COVID?
If he was in there with gangrene and had COVID and died, that's the thing. They wouldn't know.
Yeah.
You can't say it was that or...
You're like 70 years old with gangrene.
Right. Okay, COVID. No, it's like, that's how all this stuff has been so fucking arbitrary. It's like even, well, it's like we were just talking about it yesterday, too.
Fauci was silent during all the demonstrations. Now he's coming out again.
I thought he was being silent because Trump silenced
him. Oh, he's fucking starting to speak again like, yo.
About like, oh, I'm worried about a second wave.
Well, he's like, he's starting to say, oh, maybe not a second wave. And I don't know. And then he's like, we should open up like baseball or basketball. I just said something. I'm like, why the fuck are people even listening to this dude?
Why are they listening to any of them, dude? Because everybody has different shit to say. Nobody's right.
Everybody's getting paid.
They're guessing, dude.
They're all guessing and getting paid.
It's so fucked up.
Paid. Getting paid, people. That's what it's all about. It's all about that, dude. But that's a good thing, because I've been off Facebook for a couple weeks, and I don't have to see everybody's stuff. Twitter, I just... Phew, phew, phew. Oh, I like that one. Phew, phew, phew. I might retweet that one. Pow.
So with Facebook, you actually, when you were on it, you would, like... It was slower, so you were seeing more of all the shit.
Yeah.
With Twitter, you're just... You don't... Do you follow people that you don't agree with?
Yeah. Sometimes.
So you see their version of it?
Some of them I do.
And do you ever talk shit?
Yeah, totally.
Because what's the point of being on there if you're not going to talk shit?
That's all Twitter is. It's just a big shit show.
Well, and it's like nobody's changing anybody's opinion. You know what I mean? Like
everybody wants to have that zinger thing.
Yeah,
like it's retweeted.
Well, what are they? They want that whole cancel culture on fucking Twitter.
Lisa was just talking about cancel culture. She's like, "What is it?" And I'm like, "Where people will fucking cancel you? They'll go on Yelp. They'll just say bad things about you, depending on what it is. Shame you."
What an example is what you brought up about Barrel House.
Yeah, they tried to shame them.
Came out and made a comment about it, like kind of backtracking and saying we're going to try to work on being more diverse. And it's
which,
like, it's, I get it that you're a business and you're trying to be, you know, toe the line on all ends so you don't get, you know, canceled. But at the same time, they canceled you because you clearly didn't want to say anything about that shit, and now they forced your hand.
Yeah. So that's why, to me, it's like, as a business owner and our guys, they don't say anything about any of that stuff. They're like, right. Nope. We're a business.
And we're going to be a business.
And we're going to be a business. That's all we are.
We have no opinion.
We'll take everybody's
but
money.
But then, you know, that's the thing, too. If let's say a business like that in a big city like San Francisco, Seattle, wherever, then does that business, can that business still face cancel culture
Taking his hand?
Like, oh, what? How come you're not saying that fuck the police is bad? Or how come you're not saying Black Lives Matter? Like, you know, because that still happens to those businesses that try to just be businesses.
Oh, yeah, dude.
And it's like, and that's the sad thing with, so I really, really wish there was a way to go back to, like, pre-social media days. I just feel like it was better because, like, everybody doesn't need to have a fucking microphone.
Sure they do.
They just don't, dude. They just don't.
Yeah.
But then again, I don't think even people that are on Fox or CNN, they need to take their microphones away too, dude. It's like...
But then people say, take our microphones away.
I guess. Where do you draw the line, right? So just Everybody has a voice and everybody can go out there and spew fake news and doctored up photos that aren't real. Like, you know, the ones where you see somebody's holding up a sign.
Oh, like...
Clearly it's been Photoshopped to say something.
Are you talking about Jenner? Kylie Jenner?
No.
That was totally happened.
What was she doing?
She had she's like, that was someone da-da-da, but it was she was like this, and it said Black Lives Matter, but then the shadow, there's no sign.
Oh my God, dude.
She's like, that wasn't somebody da-da-da, and it's like, whatever.
Well, she's the same one, though, that I read an article where her and her, like, accountants and her family were all bullshit lying about how much money her company's worth. Like, she's not worth anywhere near what they were claiming. Like, you know, it's funny though, it's like people still love her though, because she's a Kardashian or whatever she is.
People are into that kind of stuff.
It's refuge from their own life, dude.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people, it's that whole, what do you call that? Like everybody, escapism.
Yeah.
You know, like we all need it. And some people find it in sports. Some people find it in, I don't know, shooting up police stations. Some people find it in following the Kardashians. Like, oh man, it's just so fucking weird. I don't know. I just know it's been... The last couple days in Paso have been calm.
Everything's open. Everything's open.
Friday, everything opened. You don't have to serve food.
So stoked.
You know, because food clearly was the vaccine for COVID.
Yep.
So nobody got COVID.
Yep.
But now they might, because now you don't have to serve food.
I mean, we're getting probably... Maybe 80-20 mix, 80 nobody wearing masks, 20 wearing masks.
That's what it felt like yesterday. There was a couple groups with masks, but then people in Tin City before we left, it seemed like most people were kind of like, well, it seems like most of the people that are wearing masks are business people, the workers.
That's pretty much it.
Because that's kind of like mandatory.
Yeah, and then a lot of people yesterday came from either San Francisco or LA.
Really?
Yeah.
Like as like this was their destination.
Yeah,
we're coming through.
No, this was their destination. So, I talked to a gal who was on a day trip from San Jose.
No shit.
Yeah,
she's like, I wanted to get out.
They wanted to get out. They heard Tin City was open. They love Cider House. They love Barrel House.
Damn, dude.
And so.
So it's already on people's fucking calendar.
Yeah, already on the calendar. People are coming down. I mean, it's not my business, but if it was, I'd just be like, open.
Well, we kind of talked about that from the get-go. I think for me, like, the first few weeks when they were talking about it, because I had never lived through anything like this
before. Yeah, 2 weeks. Like, it's like they said, give us 2 weeks to get everything ready. All right, cool.
And then they kept saying that every 2 weeks.
And you're like, this is some bullshit.
And then all of a sudden, 3 months later, you know. But it's like...
3 months have passed, dude. 3 months.
And we still haven't even seen the full blowout of how many businesses are going
to
go under.
No, and there's still people, like I was talking to, San Francisco still got a lot of shutdown stuff.
The bigger cities
do. The bigger cities do.
Especially the Democrat bigger cities.
Yeah, I talked to, there was a couple from Sacramento who was down, and they said, oh yeah, it's like everybody's just, fuck it.
Mm-hmm. Like, I don't give a shit anymore.
I don't give a shit.
Like, if I get it, I get it.
If I get it, I get it.
Out of my house.
If I feel sick, I'll stay home.
It should have been from 2 weeks in, right?
Like, yes.
This is how it should have been.
You shouldn't have shut everything down. Right. And the fact that they're the fear. Nobody's talking about the way they spread that fear, dude.
Through the media. And
through the media, right. Because now people are fucking terrified of something they can't see.
Well, what's funny, though, is I don't...
Oh, I think
I think it's like a 50-50 thing. Like, I don't think, I think a lot of people like me and you were terrified, but then 50% of the population is freaked out. Somebody posted something that I'm friends with on Facebook that said something to the effect of, how are all you guys that are like traveling and going out and doing all this stuff, how are you doing that? Because I just don't feel like it's right, and maybe that's just my anxiety speaking.
Yeah.
And I think it is your anxiety speaking, but you need to live true to your anxiety. If you're freaked out, stay home.
Oh, I didn't.
We've been saying that from the beginning, though. I mean,
yeah, it's fucking crazy. Well, I mean, I copy things like, over 100,000 Americans weren't allowed to have funerals. George Floyd, who also had COVID, is having three, and Joe Biden is even attending one of them. This was from 6/4, but that's the thing. It's like, it was so fucking arbitrary, right, where people couldn't have funerals for their families.
Well, how many old people they did not die of COVID-19? They died of some other bullshit they had, but couldn't the families couldn't go in and hold their
hands?
No,
they couldn't even be there. It's crazy.
So, like, what about that depression, anxiety aspect of all this?
Oh, people have such anxiety now, dude. People are like,
but they have it both ways, though. People have anxiety over COVID-19, and other people have anxiety because of shit COVID-19 did to them.
Yeah,
like the shutdown, like whether it's loss of money, couldn't see a family member. You know, you think about all those fuckers in, like, sorry to call them fuckers, all those old people in, like, old folks homes.
Yeah.
Like, where the old folks home basically says, we can have no visitors. Like, shit, like, and it's like, what a lonely way to go. Like, your last
super
days.
Lonely. And for the people who couldn't be there for their, that happened to my sister.
What?
My sister, Laura, my stepsister, her mom passed away from Alzheimer's right during all this, and she couldn't be there.
Why?
So
if she's already dying, why couldn't she go in?
Because it was in a convalescent home.
There's got to be a way to like wrap her in plastic and get her in there.
It was absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's insane. And I mean,
was she pissed?
We haven't spoken about it a lot, but she's upset.
Probably
for sure.
Hurt by it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, I don't know. My, like I said, my big thing was we
stopped.
Holy shit! That
where's
dude.
Okay.
Your dog just like is so quiet and then just barks.
Yeah, she just loud. Stop it. Hello.
Hi. How are you, Loshel?
Well, how are you? She's all right.
Oh, boy.
Bourdain! Come on now, girl. She goes to the church next door. She's old Templeton family.
That's one thing I love about this area that we live in, which, again, I think goes back to the tightness of the community when things come up. But it's
yeah.
Like, because you've told me about a lot of families that I wasn't aware of, but it's like in Paso, Templeton, even Atascadero area, there's so many like, just like lifelong, like generations of family.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like one of the, I mean, I've lived in a lot of areas in a lot of different states, and it's like, I've just seen more of that here. And I don't know why that is. I mean, obviously it's a beautiful spot. This was like always been farmland, mm-hmm. ranch land. But, like, you know, the Negrantes and, you know, other people like that.
The Hayashis and AG. The Loomises.
Yeah.
The Danas. I know more South County ones.
Well,
the Viborgs here. Yeah, the Viborgs here. The Twizzlemans.
Yep.
We've
been, like, the Woodland family. Dick Woodland, who has, like, Woodland Plaza. And Richard Woodland. You know, he started here a long time ago, Templeton, and smart dude, but he, like, all his money was made through real estate. He was, like, a smart land buyer. Like, even where the Niblick Bridge is, supposedly,
yeah.
He owned the land on one side of that and ended up selling it to the city kind of thing, or, yeah, different things like that. And then his three sons and daughter kind of...
run the show.
A bunch of vineyards and shit like that too, but I don't know, just the history of this area is phenomenal, which I think is part of the
allure.
Well, it's like when you have a thing like that shooter coming through, it's like this even though you may all disagree on how to handle a situation, the community all has like the one thing in store, and that is like, let's all be safe, we look out for each other.
Yeah,
you know, like,
it's true.
I just think that's a super, whereas like, I think when you're living in a big city like LA, like you might have that on your block, but you don't have it as a city. It's too big to feel that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Your block, yeah.
You know, because it has to do with that smaller size thing. Whereas here, we're still small enough to where even I live in Paso, you live in Templeton, like we all give a shit about each other.
Yeah.
Because when the lockdown happened here, I was like, holy shit, you know, Losh lives there, Rayanne lives there, our friend Megan and Brock live down here, and he's CHP, and, you know, you start going through the list, and it's, you know, it's like after the big earthquake, too, in 2003, it's like you just everybody coming together and just, like...
I left town.
Like, because of it?
No, we were scheduled to go to New York for Christmas, and we did.
No doubt, yeah. Really. How long were you gone?
A week
so
and a half.
You left?
We left that day. Like, the earthquake happened early, like 12 in the afternoon, 12:30.
Were you still here when it happened?
I lived in San Luis at the time. I was in my house. Me and my son were chilling out.
Right.
My wife was at work. And we're just cleaning up, getting ready to go to San Francisco and stay the night and then fly out the next morning.
So you were there, felt it?
Oh, yeah.
Any damage where you were?
Not really, no. I mean, there was a couple cracks in my house a little bit, but it was a pretty...
You had to drive up through here.
Yeah.
To get to the airport. Like, what was going on when you drove through here?
Nothing.
Kind of dead on the freeway?
Yeah, it was just business as usual, pretty much. I mean, because you couldn't see right. Downtown.
Because there was a lot of damage, yeah.
And there was damage.
Two women died.
There was damage on the 5, I heard, too. Was that the same earthquake, or was that a different one where a bridge collapsed?
Oh, no, that wouldn't have been from that earthquake.
No.
No, I don't think so. I never heard about that. Basically, the main damage was downtown Paso was annihilated because all those buildings, none of them had ever been retrofitted.
Yeah.
It was just all old construction.
Old brick.
Yeah, it's, and then those two ladies died at that jewelry store.
But yeah, we went to...
And then you went to New York.
Yeah.
That's crazy. So you were there basically 2 years after 9/11.
Yeah, but then I was there in 2001 in May. And I saw we saw the World Trade Center. Like, we stayed with our friend in Park Slope, and then we took the ferry over to Staten Island and back.
Right.
You just do it at night, so you can see the lights.
Oh, that's pretty, dude. Yeah.
Oh, it was amazing. Yeah. And then, 2 years later, went down there. I was just like, holy crap.
So when you were there 2 years later, I mean, that was still in cleanup, right? Then.
Oh yeah, dude. Like, oh, they were still totally in cleanup mode. Still in cleanup mode.
Was that a trip? How did you feel?
It was weird. I mean,
was it heavy on you, or was it
not real heavy? I was, because I had, you know, the day before, it was 2 years after when I went, so
right,
all my emotion from it was pretty much spent.
Yeah, you're right.
And by 2 years later, I was already starting to believe it was an inside job.
How do you feel today though about it?
I totally think it was an inside job.
And refresh my memory on that. You think it's an inside job, like our government alone, or our government with another government? Because I heard things, everything from like, the, you know, Israel, Middle Eastern countries in the U.S.
Yeah, there was all kinds. It was just a lot of big players.
Well, because was that a rumor, or was that true that like the Bush family was close with
Bin Laden's
family?
Yep.
Not with Osama, from what I understand, but like
with his parents.
Yeah.
With his parents, but they knew him, and Osama was a total fucking CIA asset because he was a...
Wait, against Russia?
In Afghanistan.
When we were arming him.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's like we armed him, you know, and it's like, get the
and
fuck out of here.
And all of a sudden he goes, he's like, we gotta go, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, it was... It's all horse shit.
Do you think all of those incidences throughout... Well, maybe not throughout, like, long history ago, but, like, when everybody kind of started, you know, bed buddies and shit, and, like, do you think everyone...
It's still, that's politics. That's politics, dude.
Even so, like,
think about it. When in the old days, they would just poison each other, or
right. That's they why would you cheers now.
Yeah, and so why?
You cheers. The point of cheers, and this is what I heard, is you cheers hard enough to where drinks could spill into each other.
Oh,
and it was a way of like, okay, we trust each other.
Oh,
like,
got it. Oh, that's pretty cool. I like that.
Isn't that cool?
That's pretty cool. Throughout history, just because people want power. People just seek out power at any cost.
Right.
And it just, it flabbergasts me that more people aren't saying, what is going on with, like, the power structures in the world right now?
But don't you think there's more people saying that today than ever before in history?
They're talking about issues, not like...
Like Black Lives Matter, an aspect of it.
An aspect of it.
Not like the whole...
The whole system as a whole.
Which, if you looked at the whole system, dismantled the broken shit, were able to rebuild it a certain way, it would automatically fix problems like that, right?
Exactly. It would. You would give everybody equal footing.
Right.
And not saying, I'm going to take away from fucking Johnny over there who made up a bitchin' company himself and stuff.
So you still believe in, like, that some aspect of capitalism?
For sure. Who doesn't want to fucking make money, dude?
So how would you change that, then? Like, what... Capitalism to a point where if you make this much money, then that money comes in and that goes to the greater good of the community, or
maybe only Because you still need, like...
That's tough, dude.
That's super tough. And, I mean, that's where Roosevelt came in with Social Security.
Yep.
And that safety net right there. Because yep. old people were, you know, people... There's age discrimination that nobody talks about.
100%. That still totally goes on. Right.
Totally goes on, dude. As I get older, I'm like...
Right.
I think I feel like I experience it a little bit now.
Really?
Yeah, a little bit.
Huh. Like at work or like
not necessarily at work. Or like... Just I don't want to talk about it on here, but
okay,
I'll tell you about it later.
Fair. That's interesting.
When I make porn? No, I'm just kidding.
He'll give you the website. Wait, because even back in the day, like it was even more of a struggle back then because it's like nobody had money. So when you got old, it's like you had nothing to live off.
Well, you lived with your family. When there was multi-generational homes.
Which there are still countries that are that way. Italy's very much that way.
Yeah, and that's why they had a huge problem with...
With COVID-19.
And they have a huge problem during the regular fucking flu season
right,
with that,
now,
too.
Right, but now, the only two countries I've heard of recently that have said that they're pretty much, like, it's negligible percentage is Italy and New Zealand also came out. She came out, the prime minister there came out and said that there's no... active cases of COVID in their country. And I think their population is around 10 million. So you could play. So people in the US are like, well, but they only have 10 million. Right. But it's all relative, bro. It still goes through. So let it go through our society then.
Yeah.
You know?
But not lock people. If you're going to lock them down, give them the means to be locked down. I'm sorry. That's the.
Meaning like food, financial,
yep.
be able to pay your bills.
Yep.
And for those that still want to go out and work and open their business and do their thing, let them do that.
Yeah, for sure. Like anybody who wants to keep their business open, it's like they're allowed to keep their business open.
Do you think if that should have been the thing, should they have had, what do you think then about like masks and social distancing?
Again, if you're comfortable going out, again, we shouldn't quarantine the populace, we quarantine the sick. That's what quarantine is.
Right, 100%. Right.
So
instead they
reversed it.
People.
Well, they did everybody and it's like, what the fuck? I mean, and there's 100 countries just, they're like, we need to investigate this whole thing with the WHO and what happened with this.
With China.
Yeah, they're like, this is bullshit.
Well, I keep reading more shit too, because remember in the beginning we talked about it and I thought it was completely man-made in that lab. And then I kind of backed off that because the more I was reading and listening, they were like, no, it's from this wet market and this is how it happens. And even like some infectious disease specialists on a podcast were talking about it. So I was like, oh, okay, that makes sense.
But that was the only place in China that was fucking really got the...
Right.
No other places in China...
Right.
Got it. They didn't lock the whole country down. They just locked Wuhan down.
But that, the craziest thing, though, is out of all that, now there's more articles and more articles coming out about how, well, no, but they were studying that specific COVID-19 in this lab.
Yeah.
And then, so there's still people and credible people saying that it was man-made.
You know what I mean? From the beginning. See, at first I wasn't. I was like, oh, boy.
Be careful.
Well, and I was totally careful before we shut down and everything. I was wearing gloves, and I'm like, I don't know about this. Don't know. I don't for 2 weeks, and they gave me grief at work. And now I'm like, okay.
So you were ahead of the curve.
Way ahead of it because I fucking.
But you handled it the way that no government handled it, and that is basically like, oh, there's a thing. Let's go full in right now. Let's go full in gloves, mat, whatever the fuck you're doing.
Yeah.
But. Instead, now what they're trying to say is that in either our county or in California, well, it's possible that we're going to make it mandatory.
I saw that, dude.
And it's like, wait, 3 months after we had our first case, now you're going to make it mandatory? It should have been mandatory the first day.
Exactly.
So it's all this arbitrary bull. And did you see the thing? There was another article that said that...
Well, the judge just put a hold on Gavin Newsom's, what do they call those? Executive orders. Well, they said the legislator needs to be involved, like the legislative branch. You can't just say this stuff now because the legislators are going, even Democratic ones, they're like, yo, bro.
Like, talk to us.
Talk to us. You're just doing stuff and spending money. And they're like, no,
we have a say too.
We control the purse. We're the ones who control this money.
Well, it's supposed to be that separation, right, between branches.
Yeah, but everybody, all the governors took fucking, boom.
Yeah, the Republican governors were, well, I mean, they're also the ones that they closed down later and reopened sooner. I mean, Texas and Arizona.
And they're saying there's big spikes in Florida now and big spikes in Texas.
And Arizona.
But I'm like, who's, again.
What if this wasn't COVID-19? It was just the regular flu.
How many people are dying?
But let's say it's just the regular flu and they wanted to handle the flu the same way. Cool. You saved people from dying. But now we have to reopen at some point. The flu, the cold, the whatever. Is gonna spike up when they let the kids go back to school. You don't think the COVID's gonna go up?
Yeah, it's totally gonna go up.
Of course it is.
But it's stupid.
But I'm letting my kid go back to school. I'm not gonna keep him home.
No.
Although there's a lot of parents, there was a survey that went out to Paso parents about all the public schools.
Yeah.
And one of the questions was, like, how likely are you to send your kid back if we reopen in, like, August or whenever the fuck they said they would reopen? And basically, it sounds to me like there's, like, a third of parents that basically just plan on homeschooling all next year. And it's like, what? I mean, you do you, but what the fuck, man?
They don't like the system. They don't like, it's like, all right,
well,
if I'm going to...
COVID-19, they don't want their kid exposed to, like, the kid's germs and shit.
Maybe.
And then, actually, you know what's funny, too? I also read that some parents didn't want their kids to go back because of the guidelines of making any kid over 2 years old wear a mask, separated, no recess, no cafeteria, you eat lunch at your desk in your classroom.
Hey! Mm-mm. Yeah, that's, it's just, it's...
Can you imagine a three-year-old trying to keep a mask on?
No!
I have an almost eight-year-old kid. You know what he's going to do with that mask all day? It's a distraction. It's going to be a sweat box.
Yeah.
He's going to be touching it, which is then going to be spreading more germs. I don't know, man. Yeah, it's crazy, dude.
So, but yeah, I would just open it. I mean, it's...
But help.
What are they going to do again? Because the CDC just said this week, there may be another shutdown. They said that this week, and it's like, what the fuck?
Have you noticed, too, why does CDC and WHO tend to, like... It seems like they're not always on the same page, but you would think they would be, though, right? Different organizations making different
different corps, but they're also vying for the lead.
Well, and WHO, though, okay, so WHO is the international, so that, yeah, that would be different, because, like, China's in their pocket, all the, you know, that kind of shit.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas CDC is just the U.S., okay, yeah.
Let me see if I can find that tweet real quick. Yeah, I don't agree with any of it. But that's my opinion.
So, due to what's going on then, and the fact that this seems to be ongoing, who would you rather have as president, Trump for the second term or Biden with whatever...
Neither one of them, dude. I mean, Trump's going to win.
Really? You think so?
I think so, just so they can fucking bash him for more years and do other... Because he's going along with... They're going along with everything he's doing. He's... Raise the military budget.
Right.
He's operation fucking Warp Speed, dude. Where the military...
Oh, good Lord. Oh, boy. What is that?
Oh, vaccination program.
And it's called Warp Speed?
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck, dude?
Yeah, dude.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Is Bill Gates involved?
I'm sure he is. I'm totally sure he is.
Does it have to do with vaccines in general?
Yeah,
or
like...
with COVID-19?
They're going to say it's COVID-19.
But it's going to be about across the board... Holy shit, I have not heard about that. When the fuck did that come out?
Oh, come on, dude.
I like how you expect me to know all this shit, dude.
This past...
Spend more time on Twitter than
last month or 2 months ago. I'll find it right now.
Warp Speed. That's an interesting name. As in, get it to the people and warp speed and mush their minds?
Yep.
Huh. So that's going to be like a... Bourdain. Bourdain.
Okay.
Shooter.
This was the head of Operation Warp Speed was the head of GlaxoSmithKline when they pled guilty to fraud allegations for withholding safety data over several prescription drugs back in 2011.
Ooh, ironic.
Yeah, this is who Trump put in charge of that. So I think that he is totally a part of this thing, man.
But you think Trump's a part of it, like, and that's a plan because he's got money on it, right?
Yeah,
for sure.
Oh, for sure, dude.
See, I don't think he's a billionaire, but I think by the time he's out, he'll be a billionaire. He's setting all this shit up.
Oh, it's crazy. It's fucking, yeah, they just did that one, and they're pushing just all these pharmaceutical companies, and that's, people don't understand, it's like, CDC is a vaccine-based company that's making money.
A vaccine-based company that's making money.
Yeah, and it's like all the players
I
in that...
just like a scientific research.
No, all the fucking people who head that stuff, who come in and out of it,
right.
They're from pharmaceutical companies.
That's so crazy.
They get paid by pharmaceutical companies. It's like...
Well, and Fauci being the biggest of them all, no?
Yeah, he's been there since the 80s.
Oh, he's been there for 30, 40 years.
Yeah, like and that. So to me, it's like, good, go. But, I mean, people don't like when I say that stuff either.
Right.
But that's
they don't like it because it's like they think that's conspiratorial?
Or? Oh, for sure. Like, you don't care about people. And it's like, I do care about people, but it's like, I also care about my own...
I care about what's right.
Yeah. And it's like, you don't lock down everybody. You don't do this. You don't...
Well,
you don't shame people. It's like, all the stuff that's happened from all of this... Is that the little babies right there?
It sure sounded like one.
I think there are. We got three little chicks that are hopping all around here. and they're learning how to fly right now.
It's up in this tree, no? Oh, yeah, it's... Where did... I just saw something fly down.
Oh, man. Little boogers.
Yeah, I don't know. To me, I saw the, and I don't trust polls, because, fuck, remember the polls with Trump and Hillary? Like, Hillary's going to win. But there was a poll that came out that it had Biden at 55% and Trump at 41%.
It's, to me, it's, again, if it's, if Biden does win, it's based on who his vice president is.
Oh, it's, well, that's going to be the president.
Yeah.
Well, you hear now, right now, especially, so before the George Floyd thing,
yeah,
it was, you know, people like Amy Klobuchar and stuff like that were like his top
yeah.
things. But now because of that, now what Kamala Harris, and she's done some dumbass shit in California.
She was not there for the black community whatsoever.
Yeah, she half black?
Huh?
Yeah, she's not totally black. But yeah, now
she... Because she enacted crime bills in California and was fucking...
That were fucked toward black people.
Exactly.
Right. And she... Well, she was also the one that had a thing... She had a law that came out that was something about, like, parents going to jail if they're...
Oh, yeah, dude.
School
yeah.
and shit. And
yeah.
it's like, what the... That's helpful.
That's... Get out of here with that shit.
Fucking... Well,
and well that's the state controlling everything, and right. that's... I mean, it's my opinion is that's where all of this is leading, is that the state wants to control everything.
From...
Birth like to grave,
that, all the way to like
from
oh,
birth
hey,
to the grave,
happening.
Dude.
You need to stay at home.
This is what you do.
Quarantine.
This...
I like your little breakdown though of how they use shelter in place. A lot of people call it, you know, shutdown, quarantine. But yeah, quarantine.
Yeah.
That means put the sick people away. Quarantine them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm healthy, man.
Yeah. Why are you quarantined?
Like, open my sports club so I can go to the sauna.
Yeah.
Let me stay healthy. Yeah. There was never, and I love this point too by Rogan. It's like there's. The government hasn't come out with anything talking about
health.
Be healthy.
Yeah, they're not saying
nothing.
That. They're not telling anyone to be healthy. And
immune
it's like,
system.
We're telling you, be healthy. Watch your immune system. Go on site. See what kind of, you know, spices that are good for you. Cook with those. Don't eat
What's
all
like,
that prepackaged
turmeric,
stuff.
You know, it's like
yeah.
inflammation. That's a good thing.
I don't eat it, but I put cinnamon in my coffee every morning.
That's great too. That's a...
for your blood.
Yeah, okay, yeah, because we put that in our smoothies, but it's like, eat real food. Stop eating fast food. Stop eating.
Although
like,
I did have a quarter pounder this week.
I would probably have the shits.
It was so fucking good.
Yeah, you primarily eat healthy though. You cook at home.
I do, and there's things I can't like. I was eating last night. Lisa made ravioli with cream sauce, mushroom ravioli, but I just wasn't feeling good, and it's like.
That saw that like cream
I can't eat. I had two bites and I'm like I'm sorry I can't
right
I just don't feel good and it sucks because it's like
that was probably because that fucking quarter pounder you had
no that was days and days and days ago.
Are you feeling better today?
Oh, I feel better today for sure.
What do you think it is? COVID?
Who knows?
Did you get a vaccine recently?
Not gonna have. Colorado though just went through committee. And it's going to go on to the floor. Some people are saying the bill's already passed, but stop it. It just went through committee. We're mandatory vaccinations on the whole population.
No shit.
No religious exemptions. No medical
exemptions, period.
Unless it's like a complete medical exemption.
Meaning like you would have to have proof that by taking it, it could be detrimental to your health.
Yeah.
Holy fucking shit.
So it's like there's all these things are happening these past 3 months that have nobody's aware of because everybody's fucking watching Tiger King and everybody's getting drunk in the morning. And it's like I was there with everybody.
Yeah.
You know, but
you didn't
then it's like
Tiger King, did you?
No, I never saw it.
We didn't either.
But I feel like about a month ago, I started work again a month ago, but even before
no,
that
you went through like a kind of a thick depression there for a little bit.
Probably 2 months ago.
Yeah,
2 months ago, and I was bummed, and it was like also I'm gonna stop drinking all the time. Lisa and I were like, let's do this, and you know, went back to work, and that helps. But then, the cool thing is, seeing people come back in, and just like, hey, how you doing? Where are you from? Just right. let's get back to being fucking people, and like
be as normal as possible.
Be as normal as possible. It's like if I'm asking where you're from, it's like I genuinely want to know.
Right.
If I don't ask you any questions. You're bugging me. Get the fuck out of my face.
That's some good little
tones
from
the It's the truth.
No, I get it, man. And it's like, mandatory back. I don't know.
See, but that's the shit I get down on, and that's, people are like, that's it's not a conspiracy to look stuff up. I'm not trying to.
And isn't that the crazy thing? Is that it's so easy to just throw out a name.
Yeah.
Oh, conspiracy theorist, or well, but I also like when black people say Black Lives Matter, and then a white person comes out and goes All Lives Matter. It's like, okay, you're missing. To me, you're missing the point.
Yeah.
You have not been oppressed in the last 400 years. This group has. How about we just shed some light on them, let them have the stage for some time. Let's help them get there. You know, like, I just think there's always these shame games. Or
I don't like the shame game, dude.
You're not wearing a mask. I can't believe you are.
I'm trying to figure out how to wear my mask the least amount possible. I even got it smaller, dude.
Really?
So it just covers my lips like this, and I'm
so
like,
it looks like a beak.
Yeah, Lisa's like, that's not gonna pass. And I'm like, man, I'm like, that one's good.
Yeah, yesterday he had this bandana rolled up to where it was mostly just from under the eyes here, and there was a little triangle that came down like right here.
Oh. It was a pain in the fucking ass.
Is it like?
Because this is the
on.
Well. This is the first Friday and yesterday was the first times that I was like, okay, I gotta.
Does it fuck with you?
It is not cool.
Uncomfortable.
It's definitely uncomfortable.
Probably a super big distraction too. Especially
huge distraction.
To somebody.
Huge distraction.
Remember what I told you when we're in there? So I'm like deaf in my left ear basically.
Yeah.
And so I'm I listen with my right. But I'm also become a lip reader over the last decade.
I don't even read lips. I don't give a fuck. I just think, whoa, right. That's what you said.
Okay.
I literally, all right. I don't even care.
Like, you hate Black Lives Matter. Okay.
Okay, all right.
But yeah, for me, that's what I do. And so everybody wearing a mask now, it's like, I'm like, I say what a lot more than I used to.
Well, you have to. And it's because people wear masks. Our guy came in to do the Wi-Fi stuff, and he was geared up and full shield.
No shit.
Geared up.
Oh, company type thing. Got it.
And you couldn't hear him because it was thick.
Oh, muffled, right.
It was a thick respirator one.
Like the one with the charcoal thing?
Yeah, it was a good size.
And then plus a shield over that.
Not a shield over that, but it was built into it. So it was a whole built-in mask. It was pretty dope. I mean, if I was going to go fucking do some shit, I guess.
Don't say too much.
That would wear one of those.
Yeah, so in like a year, they're going to be watching this video looking for evidence.
It's possible.
Well, dude, it's like that dude that just rolled through town. Like, you know all the investigating they're doing on that? Here's a crazy story. A friend of mine, who I won't mention, local musician, was down in SLO on like Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah.
Came out of that Woodstock pizza.
Yeah.
And that guy.
Oh, I talked to somebody who rode the bus with him back this way.
No shit.
Yeah.
Oh, so he was taking the bus as transit.
Yeah.
So this.
He could have pulled the gun out on the bus,
no
dude.
No shit. That's why. He was in Piccolo. He was in Jade Boutique. He was in Side Street. He was in Pappy McGregor's. He was on the bus with people. He was at Woodstock Pizza where my friend comes out with his box of pizza and he says, "Give me your pizza. Give me your pizza." And he was getting all in his face. My friend. He's like, no, dude, walks to his car, the guy follows him. He knows the guy's behind him. And this guy, my friend, was a longtime wrestler, so he can easily subdue the guy.
Yeah.
But he doesn't bend down to set his pizza in. He just opens the door and throws it in the passenger seat.
Yeah.
And he turns around and goes, "What are you going to do, dude?" And the guy goes, I just saw my friend last night. He, like, told me the story, like, verbatim. The guy goes like this. He goes, "Pop, pop, 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 pop." And then, like, walks away, and my friend's like, "Huh, that's weird. Didn't call the cops."
Jeez, man.
Like, but he felt like shit.
Yeah,
like,
that's, when I hear that kind of stuff, it's just like, man.
But to your point, like, even on the bus, how many people on a bus? Let's say 30 people on a bus?
Yeah. And the guy said, too, he's like, yeah, he was on the bus just talking complete nonsense.
Like, two people or just to himself?
To himself.
Well, apparently he stole, what I'm hearing is he stole the guns.
Yeah, he had multiple guns.
San Luis Obispo.
Oh, interesting.
While he was down there.
Interesting. He must have known somebody who had guns.
And then, well, there's another friend of ours who's like ex, like hardcore, was like Marine or Special Ops or some shit. And he said one of the things he learned from being overseas is like, for this guy too, like one thing that would help, if you wanted to go to another town and like learn it quick and like be able to do some shit. And like, let's say this guy came in, you want to befriend the homeless people. They hate the government. They'll help you if you're telling them that you're going to go do shit, that 9 times out of 10, they'll help you with the process.
Yeah.
Because they'll hide you, they'll hold your shit. Like, so who knows? But it's like, even with that, it's like, this is mental health. Yeah, sure, that's one aspect of the story. But like, what all did he plot and plan? Because the fact that for 2 days, he avoided them until getting shot in the vineyard. Like, that's gnarly, dude. But he was. Mental health, conspiracy theory. When I went back and looked at his Facebook page.
Yeah, people told me they did that.
Rambling ass shit, dude.
That's what I've heard.
And like some like Latin English shit, and then like almost like satanic style. It was just... I just feel bad, man, because it's like it could have been the right drug administered in the right way if for some reason it had to be mandatory or he was in a hospital of some sort.
Yeah.
And it's like, he's cool, man. Like, he's cool. But instead, it's like...
But then it's if you, you know, people, they don't want to... I knew a guy who was schizophrenic and he didn't take his medicine and just...
So what would you think then if you refuse to take medicine, but we know you're a possible threat, that not locked up in prison, but you're locked up in like that boys' home facility and you just can't leave?
I don't know. I mean,
like, would that be fair?
I don't know. That's one of those conversations where it's like you got to have people and all family members involved in that kind of stuff.
Super nuanced conversation.
Yeah, super nuanced conversation where people who know him, who've grown up with him, that need to be involved in those type of conversations. You know.
It's scary, man, because you think about how many of these things, whether it was that Dylan Roof that shot up the black church.
Yeah.
You know, the Parkland shooter down in Florida, you know, all the way back to Columbine, who I don't even know if those guys were, had mental illnesses. I know that they felt like bullied and this was their way of like going in and like having their revenge or whatever. But it's like, yeah, you hear about that latest shooting?
In Atlanta?
I saw the video.
Wendy's. Yeah.
So the Wendy's is on fire. That's done.
That's done.
No Wendy's burgers for them for a while. Turns out there was like a 40 minute video they released.
I saw 30 minutes
of it was them doing like
sobriety tests. Yeah.
And then the guy is on the ground with two white officers fighting them. Apparently got the taser gun and then started running. And then the other cop
shot. Because he turned around and pointed the taser at him. And I mean, I don't. It's
well, the taser wouldn't have got him, but yeah.
But that was the thing. He turned it around, and they just... At least it's like, why couldn't they shoot him in the legs? And I'm like, that's a great point. And I'm like, I don't... It's like, it's one of those things where it's like, there needs to be more non-lethal training.
Well, that would have been a prime time to have, like you know, the rubber bullet, for example.
Yeah.
Hit him in the back with that. Knock him down.
Knock him down, yeah.
At it again. You know, but for them, it was... So,
but I saw a video, too, where they were picking up the shells, and it's like, yo, you're fucking with
the... See, that's not good.
Yeah, you're fucking with the crime scene. And so that's where it's like, I saw that was in the video too, and it's like, what are they doing? Why are they doing that? That's a crime scene now.
So yeah,
I mean, I've watched enough CSI and shit. Come on, that's a fucking crime scene.
No, I get it, man. Like, I didn't see that part. Interesting.
But it's the same thing. It's wild, 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 man, wild.
But you know, to me, the difference. I mean, there was a difference in that between that and the George Floyd, because George Floyd was handcuffed flat on his stomach. And then for 9 minutes had that guy. You need to check out this Chappelle. Chappelle did a special.
Yeah.
About 27, 28 minutes long.
Yeah.
And there's a few funny parts in it, but basically he addresses this, and I like him.
I like him too.
He's got some interesting commentary on it, but he named it. It's literally 8:46.
That's the same time the planes went in the building.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh shit, now it's some conspiracy theory shit. You think Chauvin was involved, that cop was involved?
No, but there's pictures of him that the faces don't match up. It's weird.
Yeah, you shared something like that too, and it was like, yeah, they didn't look the same. I never know what's doctored. I don't know what
they're... You don't know what's going on. And that's the thing. It's like, you don't know what's going on. Is this a staged event? Is this not a staged event? Is it... Because there's... I mean, I see stuff where there's... I see multiple people at the same different tragedies. There's one gal on Twitter. They fucking show her, and she's been in multiple... different places, like a white Karen type lady.
Oh, and she's like just there to like kind of play like a victimish role.
Play a victim, like, and then I got COVID, and just all kinds of shit. She does all kinds of shit. And so it's like there's actual real people that
what
are going.
Call it, like crisis.
They're actors? Crisis actors.
They tried to say that shit over Sandy Hook.
Yeah, I don't.
Which I didn't buy that.
No, I didn't buy that at all, because people actually really, kids died at Sandy Hook. I mean, there's parents who don't have kids.
Teacher and some number of kids all died, yeah. And, yeah, that's... Well, Alex Jones was a big one on that. And the families got together and sued the shit out of him.
Yeah, he's still being...
Yeah, that's not over.
It's not over.
Well, Alex Jones is another one, too, where it's like... That's a fair point, too. Like, a lot of the shit he says is kooky as fuck, and a lot of it's been wrong. But there was stuff, especially early on, where there was some video he got of, like, rich, wealthy...
Oh, Bohemian Grove.
Yes. But that like is a that was a real thing.
It was real, and he was one of the first ones that talked about 9/11, and then showed loose change in these different videos, and I was like, holy shit.
What does that mean, loose change in your videos?
It was loose change was a video that came out probably 2 years after 9/11.
Right.
And it went in depth just on like what they thought, right, and the things they were seeing, and then talking about architects who came out and engineers who came out and said, this is a fucking planned demolition.
That's not how a building
that's not work. How that's not how that's not a, not even what would
I've
happen.
I've seen some of them where they say they had to detonate it a certain way because like the fact that it just stacked,
mm-hmm,
instead of like at some point teeter.
Yeah.
Which then the people that aren't conspiracy theories say that the heat basically melted all this stuff, and then it was the weight that collapsed on top of it.
A B-52 bomber flew into the Empire State Building. You can look this up, dude. And it burned for 3 fucking days.
And it never fell?
Never fell.
B-52 bomber into the Empire. B-52 or, into Empire State Building.
It was some kind of plane.
According to history.com, a United States military plane crashes into the Empire State Building on this day in 1945, killing 14 people.
The building's still there.
The freak accident was caused by heavy fog.
And how funny, it never fell.
Right? Yeah. Look at all the debris there. Look at...
Well, no, based on the photos, it never fell.
Yeah. See what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, fuck. You have fucking people standing there.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
People don't hear this stuff,
and
dude.
And that building was built...
In the 30s? 20s or 30s?
World Trade Center.
Yeah, oh yeah.
World Trade Center, isn't that the 80s?
70s.
70s. Holy shit, that's crazy.
Yeah. So...
Yeah, I never heard about that.
No, most people haven't.
Yeah.
Come on, most people haven't, dude.
Yeah, like, look, you literally have, like, a motherfucker right there,
yeah,
sifting through shit.
Sifting through it.
Holy crap. Yeah, you were right, though, a B-52 bomber.
A B-52 bomber's got to have explosives on it. Fucking gasoline, like an airliner.
Do you think that was done on purpose, or that was an accident?
They said it was heavy.
It was heavy fog. Yeah.
It was probably an accident.
That's crazy, dude. Oh man.
So you see where I see stuff like that, and I'm like, okay.
Wait, like that didn't fall, but this
fell.
In fact, like, both of them fell the same way.
And then a building over here fell, where all the accounting was for fucking, where the you know, the day before fucking 9/11. Who was the defense secretary?
Oh, Rumsfeld.
They fucking were missing $1 trillion or $3 trillion.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I remember.
And then boom, this happens, and you're like, but all the accounting was in the building over here that fell.
That's so crazy. Yeah, because it was like blocks away, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And what they tried to say is it was debris from the initial
get
two
the fuck
crashes
out of here
that just missed all this other shit and like went over to that building. Yeah.
So
wow,
you can see my.
Well, I, that's one thing I love talking to you about, because like for me, I always, especially probably pre 5 or 10 years ago,
mm-hmm,
I just bought the narrative that came out in the media.
Yeah, I don't buy the narrative
and
at all.
Now it's like, in talking to you, there's even things, because I mean, I question almost everything now, but even for you, like some of the information that you have and stuff you've read, it's like, oh wow, you know, because there's so much shit coming out. You can't know everything, but it's... I really think it's important to question shit. Don't just buy whatever like your party, your group, your team is spitting out, because here's a fact. Republicans lie. I'm not saying everything they say is a lie, but they lie. Democrats lie. Like, there's bullshit, and we have to question it and try to find out the truth. But well, they're doing a good job at keeping us divided so they can keep filling their wallets and gaining more power, like you said.
Yep.
I mean, that's what it is.
Yep. It's all power.
It's just, yeah, it still makes me want to move to the mountains, but I'm going to hang out here for a while.
A little bit.
So, anything coming up that you're looking forward to?
Doing an event. 4th of July. We're still going to party later on in the afternoon. I'm just working right now, just trying to, you know, wait until the end of July. We're going on the houseboat again.
Oh, are you?
Oh, yeah.
Is that going to be a regular thing you do through summer then, or what?
No, they wanted us to come up 4th of July weekend, but we're like, we have an event here, and I'm like, I can't. I've already got some days I got off that, you know, I'm doing a thing with our dentist for his
oh, right
employees
on.
And stuff. And
so what, for your July 4th thing, are you worried at all about another shelter in place? Like,
no.
Who cares?
No, I don't give a shit.
Yeah. I can't see.
Come, if you come by my house, come by.
Yeah.
If you don't, don't.
Are we going to walk around the neighborhood with flags and have a parade?
Maybe. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what Templeton's going to do for 4th of July.
The parade is off, though.
Parade is off.
Yeah.
The fire department just said they're doing the annual pancake breakfast, but it's a pickup. It's not, can't eat in the park. It's not
the same, dude. Come
it's
on.
Not the it's same. It's just not the same. So, no, just, I'm just chilling, you know, back to work and...
You know what's funny is, like, yeah, so they're canceling parades and concerts in the park and all that shit.
But you can,
but they're still doing these cruise nights in Paso and Atascadero.
Still doing protests downtown.
Yeah.
Like, San Luis.
Like, all that's cool. There was a thing that came out that said, it's unsafe to be in crowds unless you're going to be peacefully protesting.
Yeah, I saw that, dude.
What in the fuck?
And
it's
that was...
Okay, it's safe to be in a peaceful protest with COVID-19, but not in, like, a regular crowd at, like, a concert.
And tell me how that's not...
What? No, how fucking arbitrary is it? You know why? They don't want to piss off the peaceful protesters, because then that narrative gets...
Yep.
Right? Like, oh, now you're taking away our rights to peacefully protest. This is how the white man keep... So, like, they're constantly pivoting and, like, manipulating the fuck out of us, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I said it best, didn't I?
That was pretty good.
Whatever.
That was pretty good.
All right, Losh, this was 45, right?
45,
Which I thought about wanting to skip since Trump is 45.
Nah, but... man.
Oh, today's his 74th birthday.
Happy birthday, dude.
It's also Flag Day.
Yep.
It's the Army's 245th birthday.
Happy birthday, Army. Good job, revolutionaries.
All right, join the resistance.
See ya.